Shark Tank can make or break a business overnight, but for every big deal the sharks make, there are some huge opportunities that they've rejected, including one that made $1 billion. So here to break down Shark Tank's biggest misses is DailyMail.com's Charlie Langson. So Charlie, we've got to start with the $1 billion total whiff that was heard around the world when they all passed on the Ring doorbell system, which was originally pitched as DoorBot. So what happened here?
So in 2013, an entrepreneur called Jamie Siminoff appeared on the show, and as you said, he was pitching a system that basically allowed you to check who was at your door on your phone. So he wanted a $700,000 investment for a 10% stake in his company, and no one really bit that much apart from Kevin O'Leary. However, the offer that he was prepared to give just didn't really entice Jamie that much, and he left the show with no investment whatsoever, and he was devastated.
Well, $700,000 for 10%, that's a lot. He was devastated. Sharks didn't really love it. Here's what they said. Take a look.
I'll give you $700,000.
Respectfully, Mr. Wonderful, we're going to decline.
You're dead to me.
All right, Charlie, this did not stop this entrepreneur, though, from making it big. I mean, $1 billion big.
Huge. So he went on to rename the system, as you said. He renamed it Ring, and he actually secured a $28 million investment from a group of investors, including Richard Branson. And now the company is worth $1.1 billion, which means that their investment would have been worth nearly $110 million.
I guess we got the last laugh on that one. All right. Next up, Mr. Wonderful. We know he loves his wine. I love my wine. Charlie loves her wine. But none of the sharks could strike a deal with Copa Di Vino. And this was a pretty good pitch. What happened?
It really was. So a guy called James Martin went on the show pitching what is effectively like fine wine, but in a single-use container. But what he said is this is something completely new. He wanted $600,000 for a 30% stake in his company. And the sharks just didn't bite at all. They were having none of it. However, he's gone on to rake in $25 million in sales. So he's toasting champagne these days. Forget the wine.
Maybe in a box, too. Finally, I want to talk about a couple of deals that Lori Grenier made that made an entire fortune. But some of the sharks, they didn't love them. We're going to start with Scrub Daddy, which went on to make over $141 million in sales. Tell me about that.
Yeah, so as you said, this product is huge. She has made an absolute fortune, over $140 million in sales. That's impressive.
You knew it was gonna be good as soon as you heard the name, Scrub Daddy. It's fantastic. Lori also cut a deal with something called Simply Fit, and this one went on to make $150 million in sales. She's killing it. What happened there?
This one was huge, and this was another one that Mark Cuban dissed. So the Simply Fit board is basically an at-home fitness system. Mark Cuban slated it. He was like, you could do the hokey pokey on this thing for hours. That doesn't make it a great product. It doesn't mean it's going to do well. And it has made over $150 million. They actually raked in $9 million in sales in just 6 months. So they really did hit it big as soon as they left. And Lori's laughing all the way to the bank.
That's great for your obliques, your stabilizers, keeps the kids entertained.
Do you have one at home?
No, but I think you and I need to think about a new pitch for Shark Tank.
Maybe, yeah. I think we could come up with something great.
I'm thinking like something that turns wine zero calories.
But more alcohol?
Start researching on that. Charlie, great stuff.